Hey guys, Luca here. Today I'll show you two different setups for the Stamina Dragonknight. Both are non-proc setups, so especially made for sealed at the moment. The first one is a heavy armor build, the second one a medium armor build, both with sword and board on the back bar and twitch on the front bar. I've played it a couple of hours today and it's honestly really strong. Didn't expect that. I didn't expect such tankiness and single target burst damage. So let's go. First setup with 5x fortified breaths in heavy, 4 impen pieces and 1 sturdy with full prismatic glyphs. Then 2 small pieces, spriggans, both impen, also prismatic glyphs. 1 spriggan string and infused, and a spriggan small on the front bar with infused oblivion damage. On the back bar, I have Endurance Necklace infused with a sword and board, shield and dagger endurance with decisive and sturdy, and those juicy drain stamina poisons, and a trainee ring also infused. So full infused weapon damage. In terms of skills, Executioner or Execute, Noxious Breath for Major Breach and a AoE dot, Dizzy Swing or spammable, then Venomous Claw, one of the strongest single target dots in game, and Rally for Burst Heal, Take Flight our ultimate, on a back bar Fragment Shield for Major Mending and Minor Brutality, Race Against Time our Snare Removable, and gives also Mage Expedition. Vigor, our heal. Hardened Armor, our armor buff. Dots against a small shield. And Flames of Oblivion, really strong. Use it, guys. And as ultimate corrosive armor, you could also swap to Sword and Board if you want. Depends on the situation. As race, I'm not here, but Imperial is even, I would say, so those two races are the best. Mundus Stone, the Steed Mundus. You could also use Warrior or Serpent with 64 points in stamina. As Buffwood or Zoga, Smoked Beer Hunch for extra Magicka recovery. You could also use Arteum if you want, but I prefer the extra Makarek. CPs, nothing special. Thaumaturge to empower all dots. Deadly Aim for 10% more damage on single target attacks. Duelist Rebuff, 10% damage reduction against single target attacks. And Unassailable for 10% AoE damage reduction. Rejuvenation for sustain. Ironclad for extra armor, Slippery to automatically CC break, and Juggernaut for 10% less damage while you're CC immune. The buffed stats are pretty decent, almost 4.7k weapon damage, 1.5k stamina regen, and 1k Magicka recovery, which is necessary for all those Magicka abilities. Then 14k penetration with Noxious Breath. On the back bar, 39k physical resistance and 37k spell resistance with the resistance potions. I know it's really high, but needed since a lot of players have like 15 to 20k penetration. Crit resistance is kinda okay with 2k. Max Stam 27k and HP 33k without the Warden buff minor toughness. Now, like usual, I will demonstrate two common PvP combinations, simple and effective. Try to make sure that Flames of Oblivion, Rally and Fragment Shield is up. For minor brutality, major brutality and of course the strong dot of Flames of Oblivion. Start with a light attack, Noxious Breath, light attack, Venomous Claw, Land attack into Dizzy, fully charged heavy attack into Leap, and below 30% execute with Executioner. Second PvP combo with Corrosive Armor this time. Since they have changed Corrosive, it only gives you a max penetration for direct damage now. We have to pre-dot before we use the ultimate, so pre-dot with Noxious Breath, Flames of Oblivion and Venomous Claw, then use Corrosive Armor, and you basically spam Dizzy Swing after until the target is in execute range for Executioner. Second build with medium armor this time. Instead of Fortified Breath, I'm using Impregnable, the chest in heavy for max resistance and sturdy. Then medium boots, guards and shoulders, 2 impen and 1 sturdy. And a heavy impregnable helmet, so a 5 medium, 2 heavy setup. The other armor pieces are exactly the same as the first setup. Skills almost the same, I just swapped Elude for Race Against Time and Spellwall on the back bar instead of Corrosive Armor. Race, Food, Mundus and CPs are the same as before. A quick look on the full buffed stats, 4.9k weapon damage, same penetration, 1.4k stun regen, 1k magicka regen. On the back bar, 30k physical resistance, 28k spare resistance and 3.5k impen, a ton of impen. You could also go for more sturdy pieces, 29k HP without minor toughness and 30k stamina. I will upload some gameplay footage with both setups soon, link will be in the description below. I would say enough talk. If you like those kind of builds, subscribe my channel, like the video, leave a comment, make me happy guys. I hope everyone is fine in this crazy pandemic. Have a nice day and see you in the next video. Bye. By the way, I will participate in the GVG tournament next Friday. So the 30th April? Yeah, must be the 30th April. It will be a 4 vs 4 with 3 of my good mates, Gnorzo, Harlequin and Marco. So if you're up for it, I think it will be a stream up. If you want to see a competitive tournament, we will be in Blackreach somewhere, but we will play without CPs and of course without any proc sets. Would be nice if you could cheer us a bit for us. Just kidding. See ya.